Hello everyone and welcome back to Passion Sundays, the best way to end the week and start another. Our guest today is a professor of planetary science who was responsible for NASA's planetary mission that's all putting rockets into space. Professor Charles.
Hi.
Thank you very much for being with us today.
Sure.
I mean, it's such an interesting topic that I was even not flowing while I'm introducing it because I'm so excited. Tell me more about what you do.
Well, what we do basically is developing missions and spacecraft to send them to the planet. You know, one example people might be familiar with are the rovers which are on Mars. So we built them a few years ago and now they are exploring Mars, or we have missions which are exploring Saturn. So it's basically expanding our knowledge by sending robots to go across the solar system.
Amazing. And how did you end up doing this?
Well, it's interesting because since I was a young person, I grew up in the Middle East and then I went to Europe and then to the United States for my doctorate. I was always fascinated by space, you know, and by exploration. And I was fortunate, you know, to go to the right schools, get my education in science and engineering. And then I ended working at the Jet Propulsion Lab, which is the NASA Center, and moved up in the organization to become the director of that organization for 16 years.
Amazing. It's very unusual for a child who loved space, which we all did, to actually end up where they wanted to be. So you're probably one of the few that used to hold that little rocket and ended up doing it in real life.
Yeah, but I hope more people will do that because I think now space exploration, we have developed the technology and the capability that it could become more common, and hopefully there will be more young people, particularly in the Middle East, who have that ambition. One perfect example is the UAE now is planning a mission called Hope, you know, to send a spacecraft to Mars in 2020. And I think that's going to create a lot of excitement and inspiration for the young people to want to become involved in things beyond what we do on our own planet. So I'm hopeful for the future there will be more what the UAE is taking the lead in doing space exploration.
I love it. I mean, you seem to be very optimistic at any stage by your character. So you basically, when you were young, you were hopeful that one day you will end up doing what you're doing.
Well, yeah, I was hopeful, but I was not sure. I mean, you can never tell what happened in your life, you know, in the future. But I always say, like I tell my daughters, you have to be optimistic in this life. You have to be confident that you can achieve anything. And there is an example is... which people say, well, shoot toward the moon, and if you miss it, you land between the stars. So you have to, as a young person or an older person like me, you have to always be kind of passionate about what you do, excited, optimistic, and yes, you'll get setback. You don't get everything you plan on. But the key thing is not to be discouraged by setback, is to learn from it and actually try again and even try to do bigger things.
I love it. And obviously in your area, there's obviously been a lot of trials till you figure out what works. But that journey must have been also hard. It doesn't always come as easy as it looks.
Yeah, sure.
How do you find the passion when times are tough?
Well, I think you have to be prepared. You have to be mentally prepared that when you're doing exploration, there definitely will be setbacks. Not everything is going to work. And that happened to every explorer, not only in space, but when you look at people like Magellan. People give him the credit that he went around the Earth for the first time by ship. Well, Magellan didn't make it. Halfway through the trip, he was killed. I'm not saying that all explorers will get killed, but the point is that exploration is difficult, but the payoff which comes from it is worth it. You know, we knew that when we send missions, there is a possibility they might fail, but when they succeed, the knowledge we gain from them really changed humanity thinking about doing that. So always when you explore, you have to be prepared mentally that there could be setback. And if a setback happens, you just have to be prepared to say, okay, you know, maybe you feel bad for a day, but now let's learn from it and try again.
How can you get up again, basically?
That's right.
Beautiful. I love the passion that you're conveying about, well, it didn't work. What do? We just get back again on our feet.
That's right. I mean, you have to be passionate about that. And not only in everything you do in life. Not everything works exactly like you plan it. You know, many times things don't work well and the people who give up fall behind and the people who try again are the people who move ahead. So you need to be thinking in that mindset.
I love it. And how did you know from when you were young that this was truly your passion?
Well, I think when you look at young children, they are always curious and passionate about everything. From the time you look at a little kid when they start walking, the first time they try to walk, they fall back, but they still stand up and try to walk again and fall back. And then, so I think it's a passion and the optimism is in us as young people. And as we grow up, some people, you know, kind of start being, because of, you know, changes and setback, start being discouraged. And hopefully society will teach the young people not to be discouraged, you know, about setback, and be optimistic, being always upbeat. And it's affected, you know, by our education, by our society, you know, which is around us. So I think it's important for a country, for a society, to always look at the positive things that people can do and capitalize on that.
I love it. Professor, thank you very much for this insightful, amazing interview.
Sure, thank you.
Appreciate it. Yeah. Thank you.
Take care.
Passion, what do you think? I would love to hear your opinion. I really hope you found this interview as exciting as I did. If so, leave your comments on the blog below and do share it with your friends. And if you'd like more tools, tips, techniques, and exclusive interviews that I only share on my website, go to mustafa.com. And until next episode, live passionately.